Hi everyone and welcome back, it's Vicky here, and today I have an epic art journal video. I will be sharing about 12 art journal pages. These are mini journal pages, and I will be working with products from the new release by Art by Marlene. Now I want to create another mini art journal like this one that is going to be an Archi Arabian themed. However, this one that I have been working with for a couple of months now has many empty pages. So I want to finish these pages before I move on to a new art journal, and that's exactly what I'm going to do today. I'm going to make a little layout for each and every one of those empty pages. For that I am going to use the two cutout pads from the new collection, but since I want to create a new one with an Arabian theme, I'm going to use only images that are more generic, and I'm going to keep those lovely houses, the camels and such, for the next little art journal that I'm going to share here as well. So as I'm browsing through the pages, I'm picking up different images. I'm going to put them aside so I can use them on these pages. So from here, for example, I picked the earth. There are little tabs that keep those cutouts in the page. You can use your fingers like I'm doing here very carefully, with making sure that you are not going to tear off the cutout. Or if you like, you can snip those little tabs with your scissors. Now I'm going to flip through and just try and find more images. And from this one, I'm going to pick all those little birds that are stuck one on top of the other. And if you have a bigger page or working on a larger art journal, you can even use more of them to stack it on top. This way you can have your focal point bigger. But it works great for the size of the page that I have here. I'm also going to pop out this little princess. And I'm browsing through again and again, trying to find even more generic images. And if you want to follow along, I'm going to show you what I'm going to use to work on this page. So first of all, I'm going to use these doodle stamps. This is a stamp set from the previous collection that I have been using again and again. I'm also going to use my glue, my black archival ink, a black pen, a white pen, the cutouts, and the sticker book. So this is where I'm going to get all my quotes. Now the pages are already made, they have stenciling on top, they do have some stamping, some of them, and I did share a video on how I made all these pages, and you will find this linked at the end of this one. So here I'm using the cross hatch little stamp here, and with my black ink I'm adding some stamping all around. For this one I'm going to go with the green ink and just stamp at the back. I found that this background didn't have too much interest at the background, that's why I'm doing some stamping there. And now I'm going to bring in a little stamp that says the word love, and with my black archival ink I'm going to stamp it along the sides three times, just because I like the number three on my pages. Now for this page I'm going with those really exotic flowers. They would work great for the Arabian theme art journal, and I might use those as well again there, but I think they are great for this one too. And since you get twice the designs, I do have the option to use them in both journals if I want to. For gluing down my cutouts, I used my Nouveau Deluxe glue. Now I'm drawing some stems, and for that I'm using my black marker. I will go with black and white for the stems, just because I love that look. I find it really whimsical, and I keep going back to it again and again. So every one of those little areas is going to be black, and then in between I'm going with my white gel pen. I usually like to have borders, and for this one I'm using my black marker, and I'm drawing a very organic border all around, connecting the words love. So you see the lines are really wavy, nothing is straight here, and I think this adds more to the look. I'm switching from a thin marker to a thicker marker, just because some lines I want them to stand out even more. And then I'm going to use my white gel pen and color in some of the areas. For all these pages, first I'm doing the page and then I'm looking through the quotes to find something that fits. So here I decided to go with Stand Tall. These are stickers, so I'm just peeling it off and I'm going to stick it where I think it looks better. And then just like always, I'm going to use my thin black marker and go around that sticker to draw some lines, sketchy lines, nothing is straight here. And I finished off the page by adding some white doodling on the background. So here are some close-up photos on the first little layout where you can see all the details. The fun part about this mini art journal is that you can easily take out those pages, work on them, and then put them back in. So this is a page that is going to go here. But before I put it back in, I still have to finish off the rest of the pages. So at the back, I'm going to work with a stack of birds. I find this hilarious, and if you see a close-up photo, you will see that they are just adorable. Now I'm just trying to find a way to give them kind of a ground. I don't want them to float on my page. So for that, I decided to go with this stamp, which would work great as a border, and I did use it in many of my pages before. So I am stamping that here and there. Now I'm going to bring in another stamp to add some interest on the background. Again, I don't want this to be very vibrant, that's why I'm going with my green ink once again. And always remember, nothing has to be super neat. This is an art journal, this is something that you do for fun, and I did enjoy the whole process today. Now I'm going to stick these guys on top of that border that I created. And I did use my white gel pen and my black marker to color in some of these areas, but at the end I didn't like the look. So I'm going to bring in even more die cuts from the pad. I am going to use this part on top. Don't throw away the rest. I'm going to stick it on top of that stamped image that I didn't like at all. So I'm going to cover it up somehow. And I'm going to bring in even more of those cutouts to cover up the rest of the areas. And I didn't cut out this part of the video because I wanted you to see that I don't make always something that I like. Sometimes things go wrong, I don't like how they look, but there is also some way to save the page. You don't need to throw it away or cover it up completely. So this is what I'm doing here. I'm just picking bits and pieces from the cutout pads, and I'm covering up the areas that I don't like, and at the same time notice that I'm giving them something to stand on top, which is what I was planning to do from the beginning. And I think that these two little cutouts are perfect for that. I'm going to use my scissors and cut out the excess. And there are plenty of those pieces in the pads in different color combos, which make great borders. In all my pages, I like to bring in my white gel pen to add some highlights here and there, on their noses, on those pieces that I stick all around. I really like the look, and I think that having those highlights throughout the book in all the pages, it makes the book look more cohesive. For this page, I went with a sticker that says I'm a little crazy in a big way, and I think it is really appropriate with those crazy birds one on top of the other, and you will see them better in the close-up photos. Now, I always like to cut out larger stickers to smaller pieces. I'm sticking them down again with my black pen. I'm going all around to draw some sketchy lines, and to finish it off, I'm going to add some white doodling on the background. And you can see here some finished photos. Moving on to the next page, and this time I'm using the earth, and I want another way to create a ground somehow where I can place my globe. For that, I'm using this collage paper from the new pad, and I'm just going to cut out a piece and stick it down there. Again, remember, you can stick down things with your matte medium, you can stick it with any type of glue that you like, with a glue stick or with a double-sided tape. It's really up to you. I like to use my Nouveau Deluxe glue. I like how it doesn't clog on me and it has that fine tip. That's why I keep using this again and again. So anyway, I'm now going to stick the globe on top, If you like, you can use a black marker to go around the edges before you stick down the cutouts. This is going to help them stand out even more. It creates kind of a shadow all around. Another way to go is once you stick them down, you can create a shadow with your watercolor markers. You can use your black marker and draw all around it. There are different ways that you can work with these cutouts. I am switching from one way to another, just depending on the mood that I have on that moment. For my quote on this page, I went with stop to see the beauty along the way, and I think this is really appropriate for this page, especially since it has that plane that flies all around the globe. Since I have a black quote, I'm going around it with a white gel pen. I'm also adding my highlights, and for the background, just to add some more interest, I'm using a white paint marker. This is by Arteza, and I'm adding some positive signs. So here are some close-up photos on this page, and the page with the girl is another one that I will be making of this video later on. For the next page, I'm going to work on this blue one, and you can see that this already has some stamping and a stenciling at the back. I picked those three designs from the paper pad and I'm going to stick them down. It is the same design but in a different size, so it makes it look more interesting. I did use my scissors to cut out a little strip from one of those collage pages. And if you know me by now, you know that I don't like my focal points floating on the page, so I always need to ground them somehow. That's why I'm using that black and white piece there, and I'm going to stick on top my owl. Since the background is very colorful, to help him stand out a little bit more, I'm using my black marker this time to draw all around him. Also adding some sketchy lines around that collage piece. Now to my white gel pen, I am making those white areas even more prominent by going over them, and of course my absolutely necessary highlights. For my quote, I went with a sticker that says sometimes you win and sometimes you learn. And I think this is appropriate, especially since we have an owl and this is the representation of wisdom. I did go with my black pen around the stickers to add some sketchy lines, and you can see here some close-up photos. And I know that since I do that much video editing, it looks as if I'm making the pages in a minute, but it's not like that, trust me. I struggle with the position or how I am going to put things together, but this is the finished result. So here I decided to work with blues on top of this background just because they are going to stand out nicely. This is again one of the cutouts. I'm going to stick it down, and on top of it I'm going to place the girl. So again, I have something to ground my cutout, my main focal point, and I think it fits nicely there on top. Of course, I'm going to use my scissors to cut out all the excess paper. And looking through the stickers, I found one that says be brave enough to listen to your heart. And again, I think this is really appropriate since she is holding a heart. And I always suggest to find a quote that really matches your focal point. This is going to make the page come together. Now the background looks a little bit plain, so again I'm using one of my doodle stamps. I'm going to add some stamping back there with my black ink. And of course I'm going to bring in my white gel pen and add the highlights on the girl as well as on the background. I also brought out my white paint. This is again by Arteza. This is acrylic paint in a form of a marker, and I like it because it writes nicely and it is opaque. Also, it has a very thick nib, which is a great alternative for thicker details when I don't want to use the very fine tip of my white gel pen. So again, here are some close-up photos on this page, and again some sneak peeks on another page that you will see in a minute. And I told you this is going to be an epic art journal video since I'm sharing so many pages in one video, and let's move on to the next one. For this one, the focal point is going to be this girl who is holding the earth on her hands. I am stealing the idea that I had in a previous page, and I'm using those cutouts to ground my little girl. I'm sticking everything down with my Nouveau Deluxe glue, and I'm bringing in my sticker book. And I picked this time a lovely quote which matches perfectly with that girl. And it says, "Shake the world in a gentle way." In these sticker books, you will find those quotes twice, which means that you don't have to be frugal with them. There is always another one that you can use. One of them is going to be with white background, and the second one is going to be with black background. So you can choose whatever stands out better on your page. Now here I used my black marker to draw a very organic line along the edges. And with my white paint marker, I'm going to color it in. I'm also going to add some dots here and there on the background, and of course my favorite highlights with the thinner gel pen. And again, here are some close-up photos on this page. And at the end of this video, you will find a flip through on this mini art journal, which I am absolutely in love with. I think it is super happy with all those vibrant colors. So let's move on to another page. This time I'm going to work with that princess, and I think it stands out nicely on top of this background. Always note what color is your focal point and your background. So I would never stick a yellow piece on top of this background or a green one. It wouldn't stand out nicely. So in any case, I'm browsing through the pages of those collage papers to try and find something that would match with what I have here, so that I can create a little border. And I went with these bluish papers just because they match nicely with the color of her hair. So I'm going to stick those all around. Remember, this is collage paper, which means that it is super thin and it's going to blend nicely with the rest of the page. It's not going to stand out at all, no texture whatsoever. I have the edge that comes towards the page a little bit crooked. If you notice, I used my scissors to cut out those strips of paper with a curve, just to make it look more interesting and whimsy. I'm using my scissors to cut out all the excess paper, and then with a black line I'm going to help them stand out even more. With my thick white marker, I'm going to add some dots here and there, just to add some more interest on the background. I want to make them look as if they are splashes, completely random. And then I can stick my girl on top. Now on the cutouts, there are some hearts that have wings. I cut out a wing out of this tiny little heart, and I'm going to stick it on her back, so it looks as my girl has wings. And now it matches perfectly with the sticker quote that I'm going for, that says, "With brave wings, she flies." And I think this project is really easy for a beginner. If you are new to art journaling, you are going to have so much fun playing with these cutouts. Just find quotes that match the cutouts, create little journals, and especially if you are working on a mini art journal, it doesn't seem so overwhelming, since you don't have such a big space to cover up. When you are a beginner, I would suggest to start with a smaller art journal, just like this one. So here is another really quick and simple one. This is going to be the center of my book. So it is a double spread. I did use the bigger butterfly that completely covers up one of the pages. And on the other one, I went with the quote that says, "If you have to choose a color, choose rainbow." And I think it matches with the butterfly, since it has all those colors there. Now again, with my paint marker, I'm adding some doodling on the background, and I like to have the same doodling on both of these pages, so they seem as if they are actually a part of the same double spread. Moving on to the next one, and this time I picked up three of those circle flowers. You can stick them down and draw stems, just like I did for the first one of the pages that I shared today, or just create a little cluster with those flowers floating on the page. Now, floating isn't something that I'm going for usually, but this time I managed to do it, and I think I absolutely love the result. Now, for the quote, I went with one that says born to create, just because I think I am. And since this is a black background quote, I'm going to use the white gel pen to add the sketchy lines around it. Of course, I'm adding the highlights, just like always. And I'm going to show you a trick here, which I just realized, and I absolutely love it. I will be working with that on the next pages as well. You can use one of those doodle stamps and add on top white paint with that Arteza marker. And then you can stamp with that. And I absolutely love the result. These Arteza markers come in a set with way more colors than the ones that I'm using in this video, and I think I'm going to make a review because I have been playing with them for a few days now, and I think they are great for art journaling. They have thick nibs, and the paint goes nicely on top of other mediums. So anyway, I'm going to put that aside, and here are some close-up photos on this page. And since this is an endless art journal video, let's make one more page. This time I'm using this huge cutout of that girl with the flowers. I'm going to stick her down, and since this is quite big, it's going to cover up a huge amount of the background. The girl has that circle around her with those black and white lines, and this is exactly what I'm trying to recreate around the border of this page. So I try to bring things together by recreating things, repeating the patterns that I find in the cutouts. So I colored my black areas, and now I'm going to fill in between with white. And since I fell in love with that white paint marker, I'm going to add some dots, again, really randomly, like as if they were splashes. And again, I'm going to do my doodling with my white and black pens. For the quote, I went with a sticker that says confetti in my hair, but I don't care. I think this is really appropriate, and to make it fit better with the girl, I'm going to use my white gel pen and add dots of white dots on her hair. So this is going to bring those two together. Here are some close-up photos on this page, and fear not, I have more pages for you. So let's move on to the next one. For this one, I went with this cutout with the moon and the sun, and I think it matches perfectly that background. I did use some of the stars. Again, I just popped them out of those paper pads, and I'm just sticking them all around. And for the quote, I'm going with one that says, "Dream without fear, love without limits." And when I see the moon, it always somehow brings the word dream to me. That's why I think that these two fit nicely together. Now, I chose to go with the quote that has the black background because I think it is standing out better on my page. I'm using my doodling with my black and white pen. And finally, I'm going to do the same trick that I did on the previous page, where I'm using that white paint to add color on the stamp and then stamp all around the page. This is the easiest way to stamp with white, and I like the fact that this is acrylic paint, which means that it's going to dry permanent. Again, here are some close-up photos on this page. And I know that this video is getting super long, but I promise the next page is going to be the last one. This time I'm working with the earth, and I love that it has a heart drawn on top. And I wanted to use some little houses on top of the earth, so I decided to grab those two houses from a previous pad, from a previous collection by Art by Marlene, because I didn't want to use those Arabic houses. I am saving them for the next art journal with that Arabic theme. So anyway, I'm going to stick those flowers as well. And I'm using my scissors to cut out the excess paper, having everything nice and neat. For the quote, I went with the one that says, "Create your own whimsical world." I'm going to cut it in half, stick it down, and just like I did with all the previous pages, I'm going to add my white highlights, I'm going to do my black doodling, and add some dots on the background. And finally, here are some close-up photos on the last page for today. The new collection by Art by Marlene is now available at Joggles and it is on sale. If you like something, move fast since I know that they sell out super quickly. I'm gonna leave you with a quick flip through this mini art journal. I hope that you had fun today and that you got inspired. Have a lovely weekend!